So the secret's out. Not going to GCU anymore. What's up, you guys? I'm Caitlin. Welcome back to my channel. And as you can see by the title, today is a little different video. I'm actually talking about why I'm not going to Grand Canyon University anymore. So this decision has actually been super hard. It took a whole lot of going back and forth. But just with everything going on in the world, there have been many businesses, schools, and even people that have been really showing their true colors. Grand Canyon University just happened to be one of them, unfortunately. But before we get into the video, make sure to subscribe down below and hit that notification bell so you can be notified every single time I post. With that said, let's get into it. Okay, so first, I just want to say that I do have all my notes written down right here. So if you do happen to see me look down, that is why. But yeah, I'm just going to get into it because there's a few reasons. First, from the beginning, me and my mom, we were the main ones that talked with Grand Canyon University. We just had some problems going on at first, and Grand Canyon didn't exactly tell the whole truth about the living situations. And so we had a lot of misunderstandings at first. So I was already kind of like, well, this is weird. They like said it's going to be this way and it wasn't exactly this way. So essentially Grand Canyon tells you that you can create a roommate pair. So that would then become you and another person are choosing one room. So kind of like a package deal. With that said, at first I wanted to do a double occupancy. It's essentially where there's two people, a common area, and two more people, and that makes up one room. They also had at least said to me to make it seem where I thought I was going to pick my roommate pair and I had her, and then I would also get to choose the other people that I was living with. What they didn't tell you is that those people might have a different time than you. You guys might not pick fast enough, and there's just like other things that could happen, which is super unfortunate. But, and it wasn't even very bad. I just wish I would have known this before, because then we could have planned a little better. So another big part of this, like a major part of this, was the fact that I just recently moved to California. If you've watched some of my videos before, I'm sure you've heard me talk about it before, but if you are new or just haven't heard me talk about it before, I moved to California about a year and a half ago, give or take, and quite frankly, I'm not ready for like a big change again. I've lived a lot of places and I'm kind of just wanting to get settled here, like know my way around before I give another place a shot again. And along with this, I have already lived in Phoenix, so I just kind of felt like Arizona wasn't really the place for me right now, as I'm still exploring the place that I'm in. Los Angeles has so many things to do and I haven't even done half of them, I feel like, and this quarantine has not helped. I've only been going to the beach because that's pretty much the only thing that's really open that I feel is still pretty safe. You can still keep a good distance between people. So the next thing that I want to talk about is the amount of racism at Grand Canyon University. Personally, with everything going on in the world, if you don't know, quite frankly, I've personally lost plenty of friends and have been having those tough conversations with a lot of people. But Grand Canyon University just kind of reminded me that they acted more as a business first than an actual school. People were practically begging them to put out a message about everything that's going on in the world, with just the overwhelming amount of racism that's going on in the world, and the fact that they hadn't said anything. And when they did, a lot of people were upset, along with myself, because a lot of people essentially felt like they weren't really taking the time to talk about it and fully understand it and agree that they stand with us. And while I was super frustrated about this, I was even more frustrated to learn that there were many accounts of racism on campus with clear evidence of it, and Grand Canyon University had not done a single thing about these. So that really frustrated me, and I did not feel supported as much. I feel like if I'm going to go somewhere, if I experience racism, I'm going to speak up about it. Grand Canyon isn't the most expensive college ever, but as much as I am paying for that school, I would expect them to have my back if there were some accounts of racism, and not feeding into it by completely ignoring it or telling students that they will get to it and then kind of sweep it under the rug. So that's how I felt. these issues may have been resolved now, but they were a while ago. And quite frankly, if something happens, I wanted to get dealt with. The only big organization that I saw, personally, I did not follow all the accounts that GCA ran, but I did follow the dance team, and they seemed to be the only organization run by Grand Canyon University that I saw that was really taking action. They had spoke on the issue of racism multiple times and how that they stand, that they completely stand with their Black community, because their community wouldn't quite be the same without those community members. And personally, if I was on the dance team, I would have been more than thrilled to have seen that. But because this was the only organization that I saw, it just kind of hurt me that Grand Canyon couldn't speak up. So that was just a big issue for me. Racism is something that I've grown up with, and that I just don't feel like I should be paying for it. So while Grand Canyon happens to be putting out these pitiful messages, the college that I was actually going to, I was going to protest that their school had been holding, and I just felt so loved and so heard with the school. So this was just a big issue for me, and I just couldn't quite look past it. The last major thing that I had found out, not even until recently, I had found out that if you take classes there, your credits may not transfer. And while this actually might happen with a lot of schools, Grand Canyon won't transfer to most schools. And so I thought it was because it was technically a private school, because it is a Christian school. But come to find out, they don't write their curriculum so it can easily transfer to most schools, because they essentially want to hold you there. Because if your credits won't transfer, you can either stay with Grand Canyon or whatever school it might be, or you can start college back over. Personally, I want to get my degree in 4 years. So that was a big thing. That was a huge shocker to me. I didn't know that. My mom actually found that out, and I think that just kind of pushed me over the edge. So those were my major reasons for not going. I'm actually going to be going to California State University, Northridge, and I'm just going to talk about why I decided this school over Grand Canyon University. So first, my parents want me a little closer to home, more specifically my mom. She's been trying to get me to go to this school for so long, and I just kept pushing it off and pushing it away. But after some consideration, now she is ecstatic. Now she's practically ecstatic that I'm going. Along with that, I would be able to take my car on campus if I do live on campus, and which means that I would still be able to keep my current job, which I actually really enjoy right now. And I also wanted to have a car to get around, so my mom was not letting me take a car first semester to Grand Canyon University, just so I can make more authentic friends. But because CSUN is considered a commuter school, a lot of people will already have cars, so that won't be as big of an issue. Along with that, CSUN is actually cheaper than Grand Canyon University. Through CSUN, I could graduate with little to no debt, which makes me very happy, because I plan to live this beautiful life. I already live a beautiful life, but I plan to do a lot with my life, and I just feel like debt would get in the way with a lot of it. So I just feel like that's one issue that if I can tackle, if I don't have to deal with, then there's no real reason to add that to my list of potential issues. So that just seemed like a good idea for me. Next, because it is relatively cheaper, I could either save even more money by staying at home, or I could get an apartment either on campus or off campus. California's not cheap, so I've actually been considering staying at home. Hopefully I can make some more of my own rules, mom, dad, if you see this. But yeah, that's just another way to save money. The only issue with getting an apartment is rent is just rent. It does not account for appliances, the heating, the cooling, the water. Like, it doesn't usually account for all of that. I love the idea of living kind of sort of on my own. I would still get some friends with me, of course, but I had that option, or I even had the option to stay at home and save even more money. So I really enjoyed that. So there are a few more reasons why I'm not going to Grand Canyon, but they're just little small reasons that just happen to add up together to finally make my big decision. I have made plenty of friends that are going to Grand Canyon, and I don't want you to think that because I'm not going, we can't be friends. The fact that Grand Canyon is cheaper and that I do have a car means that I could actually go, still come down to Arizona, and we can still be friends. One of my best friends is still going to college in Arizona, and I still hope to visit them. So I'm still willing to make friends and keep those friendships that I made that are going to Arizona. But if we did like make a connection, or you guys were like so excited, I was so excited to meet a whole bunch of you. But there were just so many issues at Grand Canyon that it was just constantly in the back of my head, and I couldn't end up seeing past those, which made me make my final decision. So this does not mean that we cannot be friends. Please do not think that we can't be friends. But I did just want to put that out there. So without making this video too long, thank you guys so much for watching. And please remember that we can keep our friendships. We really can. If you're still going to Grand Canyon University, I would so love to meet you guys. If you live in California, I would love to meet you even before you go to Grand Canyon. Or if you don't and you live either just somewhere else or you just live in Arizona, I would love to come and see you. So thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you in my next video.